Clayoquot Sound is located off the west coast of Vancouver Island and is a beautiful area of inlets surrounded by ancient temperate rainforest. It's home to Skookum John. He's from a Housat First Nation and runs his own water taxi and whale watching business.
In my eyes, it's the best place to be. I mean, the beauty here is amazing. I mean, you know, you'll never find this anywhere else in the world, never.
But Clayoquot Sound has also one of the densest concentrations of open-net salmon farms in British Columbia. Cermak Canada owns 15 farms in the area, and earlier this year, 7 of those farms were infested with sea lice. The infestation worries Skookum John.
Wild salmon's going to be extinct. It's hard to swallow that. We need the wild salmon. If they're extinct, so are we. They feed us, they feed the animals, and when the animals eat it, they take it into the woods, and what does that do? It fertilizes our trees. And what do our trees give us? They give us oxygen.
Sea lice occur naturally in the wild, but in small crowded fish farms, the problem is multiplied. Under the Federal Department of Fisheries and Oceans regulations, salmon farms must ensure adult fish aren't infected by more than 3 active sea lice. But Cermak's monthly reports show fish were infected by up to 30 in April. Linda Sams is the Sustainable Development Director at Cermak Canada. She's also a biologist who's been working in aquaculture for 30 years. She says the outbreak was mostly due to unusually hot, dry weather that affected water quality.
For the past 10 years in Tofino, we have not really had a sea lice issue like we saw in this last 6 months.
In late August, Cermak voluntarily closed one of its farms. The fish were treated for sea lice using both hydrogen peroxide baths and the pesticide Slice. But due to poor health, the fish were humanely euthanized.
At the end of the day, the responsible thing to do there was to actually close that site down. It was a hard decision because it's a big business move for us to do that.
But the problem with sea lice isn't just with fish in the fish farms. The infected farms are located on wild salmon migration routes, which compose a serious threat to wild juvenile salmon on their way from fresh water to the open ocean. A new report from Raincoast Research and Living Oceans claims that 96% of juvenile wild salmon in Clayoquot Sound this spring were infected with an average of 8 lice per fish, some as many as 50. The report also states that sea lice in Clayoquot Sound have become resistant to Slice, the only pesticide approved to kill sea lice on Canadian fish farms. Skookum John fears an entire generation of wild juvenile salmon has been wiped out.
Having these sea lice attack those baby fish when they're coming from the rivers, you know, 50 of them on there. It only takes one of those sea lice to kill a young fish.
A Housat First Nation, where John lives, has a partnership with Cermak Canada. The fish farm owner provides jobs and economic and social benefits to the community. But Skookum doesn't believe any benefits outweigh the possible consequences.
Makes me pissed off, and, you know, we never needed a company like this.
In an effort to not have a sea lice outbreak in the future, Cermak has invested $12 million into a custom-built barge that they say will remove and capture sea lice using pressurized water. The new hydrolicer will be used alongside Slice and hydrogen peroxide baths and is scheduled to arrive in the spring. Lori Hamlin, APTN National News, Clayoquot Sound.